am extremely honored to be giving you this speech before you today. Congratulations to all the graduates before me and to your families that are here celebrating the milestone in your life. I distinctly remember sitting in my eighth grade English class, writing a letter to ourselves that we would receive a few weeks before our senior graduation. I remember being excited for this day to come, and I knew our lives would begin. This will and won't be a traditional graduation speech, because there is nothing traditional about graduating in July. In my last year, it has been an absolute roller coaster for many reasons. The school year has proven to be demanding on all of us because of this pandemic. However, the LTHS faculty and students have been extremely caring, generous, and patient with helping all of us continue to progress in our last year. They have kept our heads held high and are continuing to give us hope for the future. Lockport has given me many close friends to keep my head up, as I'm sure was done for many of you. I know we are all excited to finally be able to move our tassels from right to left and begin our journey into the world. We have all worked hard for this day, given the setbacks and the delays, but it is safe to say we have definitely earned this one. If I had one message to the world, it would be to keep your eyes open, because this group of people tend to move fast in life and have proven to overcome great things. As Eleanor Roosevelt once said, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. What she means is if you believe you can do it, then there is nothing standing in your way. So, to the class of 2020, go out in the world and do what makes you happy. Shine as bright as you can and enjoy your own journey into life. We stand here on the precipice of the future and it is in our hands. It is no longer a distant reality anymore as it begins today. Our principal, Greenan, says, once a porter, always a porter. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Carrie Green, the principal at Central Campus, and at this time, I'd like to announce our Class of 2020 award winners. We'd like to start off by acknowledging the members of the Class of 2020 who had 4 years of perfect attendance. Michael Cheehy, Connor Feldman, Alexei Herrera, Olivia Miller, Matthew Namikas, Lauren Phillips, David Placencia, Audrey Reed, Trevor Shingler, and Angelina Ungaro. Congratulations to our perfect attendance recipients. The next set of awards are for students who have earned a cumulative grade point average of 4.0 for all 4 years in high school. Katerina Clemensos, Patrick Kozek, Alexi Lippmann, Michael Lopresti, German Moreno, Alexis Nichols, and Michael O'Callaghan. Congratulations to our scholars on their 4.0 GPA accomplishment. The final two awards are for the Class of 2020 Salutatorian and Valedictorian. This year's salutatorian is Aiden K. Peugeot. He's the son of Dave and Cheryl Peugeot. Aiden is incredibly honored to be recognized as a Lockport Township High School Class of 2020 Salutatorian. During his time at LTHS, he participated in cross country and track as a varsity runner all 4 years and a two-time state qualifier. His fondest memory at LTHS was qualifying for the cross-country state competition during his sophomore year, completing their underdog season. Aiden would like to thank his mom, Cheryl, his dad, Dave, and his siblings, Lucas, Noah, and Genevieve, for being so incredibly loving and supportive. He would also like to thank all of his friends, coaches, teammates, teachers, and peers for everything they've contributed to some of the best years of his life. He would like to have a special thank you to Coach Razzo, Mrs. Pratt, Dr. Gilbert, Mr. Champlin, Mrs. Bickelman, and Mrs. Garrison for being incredible teachers and mentors. Aiden will be studying mechanical engineering at the University of Alabama, Huntsville in the future. He would like to contribute to growing aerospace projects that plan for sending mankind to Mars. Congratulations to Aiden. The Class of 2020 valedictorian this year is Patrick D. Kozek, son of Andy and Renata Kozek. Patrick is extremely honored to be the valedictorian of the Lockport Township High School Class of 2020. During his time at LTHS, he participated in the math team, the YC Academic Challenge, and Spanish Honor Society. He also served as the treasurer for the National Honor Society. Patrick has many fond memories from the last 4 years, especially all of the labs Mr. Champlin demonstrated in Physics 1 and Physics C, particularly the Friction Lab. Patrick would like to express his sincerest appreciation to his family and friends for continually offering their love and support through it all. He would also like to thank his excellent educators and peers, namely Mr. Champlin, Mrs. Wyrock, and Mrs. Stanky. Patrick will be attending Princeton University in the fall and majoring in mechanical and aerospace engineering with a greater focus on aerospace engineering. He hopes to contribute to the advancement in aerospace technologies, particularly in the field of space travel. Congratulations to Patrick, and congratulations to all of our award winners for the entire class of 2020.
Class of 2020. My name is Dr. Robert McBride, and I am the very proud superintendent of Lockport Township High School District 205. And on behalf of our seven Board of Education members, Board President Ann Kaneva, Vice President Lisa Bickus, Secretary Veronica Shaw, Mrs. Luann Johnson, Mr. Dick Ives, Mr. Michael Travis, and Mr. Michael Lewandowski, let me congratulate you on earning your diploma and graduating from Lockport Township High School. It's my job to certify that you have completed all of the graduation requirements of our district and the state of Illinois. And indeed, you have just done that. Your faculty, your staff, your community, and your parents are all very proud of you. And I know you've heard it 1,000 times. We are all so sorry that this spring was not the spring that you, the class of 2020, thought it would be as you graduated high school. Our graduation ceremony is an effort to make that up to you in some small measure. So first I want to tell you a little bit about the ceremony that you either will go through if you're seeing this video before the ceremony, or you went through if you're seeing this video afterwards. We've done a few things to signify your place in history and tradition in our district. First, you will line up and you will enter into the building and be in Lockport Township High School East Campus. The building itself and being in it symbolizes all of the Porters that have gone before you, who graduated from Central before it was a freshman center, who graduated from East Campus as Porters. Being physically in the building symbolizes that very long, over 100-year tradition that you will be part of when you become an alumni. Second, we've asked you to come with your parents or guardians or with two guests. Those people will walk with you down to the auditorium, and that has some symbolism in itself. It's likely that your parents, your guardian, your guests, they've walked many years with you, not just your 4 years in high school, but they've walked maybe 18, 17, 19, depending on how old you are, years with you as mentors, as guides, as your original teachers. It's important that you make that journey with them together. When you take that journey, you will be walking down the hallway into the auditorium. You'll be standing and you'll have your name read. And much like me, you'll be doing it in a costume. You'll be wearing a gown and you'll be wearing what's called a mortarboard as a cap. And many people don't know the symbolism of that outfit, of that costume. It comes from the Middle Ages and universities and colleges that were created in Europe. And when students went to university and college in Europe in the Middle Ages, they were required to wear the gown to symbolize that no matter rich, poor, strong, powerful, or commoner, that once they put the gown on, they were all the same. And for your graduation, when you put that gown on, you walk and receive your diploma, you hear your name read, it doesn't matter who you were, what you were in high school, you are all Porter alumni now. The hat is one of the strangest looking hats. I think it's a little bit stranger than the hat that I'm wearing that symbolizes that I have a doctorate. It's called a mortarboard. It has a flat top and it's got a bowl. It had a function in the Middle Ages. Students who were at college and university were expected to go into the marketplace to use that hat to beg. The expectation was that they would look to the community that supported them for food, for money. So the flat top could be someplace that people in the community could place money or food. The bowl could be flipped over and be used in a similar way. Today, we ask you to wear the mortarboard to symbolize that this community and all of its citizens, from Homer Glen to Crest Hill, Fairmont, right here in Lockport, have sacrificed their treasure to support you and give you this high school experience. At the end of your journey, you'll step out of the auditorium and you will step out into the rest of your life. Like so many porters before you, you're stepping out into a world that wasn't necessarily of your making. Over 100 years ago, some porters graduated and stepped out into World War I. Some into the flu epidemic of 1918. Others into the Roaring Twenties. Some into the Great Depression. Many went off to serve in World War II, both women and men. Some into the Korean War, the prosperity of the 50s, the tumult of the 60s, the innovations of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. And you walk out of the door into a pandemic, an economic crisis, a health crisis, also a social justice crisis, as people have taken to the streets these days over racism. And a question remains for you. What will you do about it? You are stepping out into a world that people my age have created. And for 18 years, you've had to play by the rules that we, the adults, have set for you. And now, it's time for you to make the rules. As a young and a new adult, going off into the military, and if you are, thank you for your service, going off into the world of work, an apprenticeship, cosmetology, 2-year college, 4-year college, and beyond. You will have the opportunity to make the rules, to look around you right now and ask yourself, am I pleased with the world that I am in? And whether you say yes or no, you as a professional, you as someone at work, you as someone as a parent, a citizen, a community member, an alum, you will have the opportunity to set the rules and create the world for the next 20 or 30 years so that when you are at your 30-year reunion for Lockport Township High School, you'll have the chance to look around and ask yourself when you're my age, what kind of world did we create? So, do you think you can do a better job than I did? Than people my age did? Well, actually, I think you can. And your performance these past 4 years at Lockport Township High School makes me confident in you. It makes me proud of you. And more than anything else, it makes me trust you with this country and this community's future. So class of 2020, thank you, congratulations, and here is to your stepping out into the rest of your life. Thank you.
Welcome to our 2020 graduation ceremony of Lockport Township High School. I am Ann Lopez Caniva, board president, and I'm very honored to stand in front of this screen and give you a few words of wisdom during these very turbulent times. While we cannot gather in the traditional way at the field house, we want to recognize and celebrate Lockport Township High School's class of 2020. We are here today celebrating not just what you have accomplished at LTHS, but all the work that led you to this point. I also need to commend you on your resilience when COVID-19 threw a curveball at all of us. You endured some unique challenges. A commencement ceremony is one of our community's most beloved traditions, and it endures despite the pandemic, economic downturn, and other times of crisis because it embodies our mission, our care, and our love for one another. Graduates, you've earned a special place in LTHS history. You were the first to have a graduation parade. You finished your last semester online amid the pandemic. Although you missed out on traditional milestones like prom, final games, award ceremonies, band and choir concerts, and the musical play, it should not diminish the joy and excitement of this incredible day, your graduation day. LTHS, like many other schools across the country, had to make bold decisions over the last several months as the scope of the coronavirus pandemic was growing. You and your fellow students have been at the heart of those decisions, which were driven first and foremost by our desire to prioritize your health and safety and that of our school. At a time which you may have relaxed and enjoyed the tail end of your years of hard work and success at LTHS, you have managed the stress of the uncertainty and have stayed the course. I am proud to say that you are a united class. Board of Education, administrators, and staff of Lockport Township High School, and all of our graduates, join me in honoring the parents, family, and friends. While you no doubt have great pride for all that your loved ones have accomplished, please take a moment to acknowledge your own success, for the role you have played in helping them through their high school years, for the personal sacrifices you have made along the way, and the support you have given them. We thank you and we honor you with our applause. At the same token, we also thank you, graduates, for bringing LTHS many accomplishments from academics, sports, clubs, and fine arts. We also thank you for making LTHS a top 9% nationally recognized school and just recently ranked by U.S. News and World Report as being the best high school in 2020. Now for my few words of wisdom. The future is uncertain, and everyone says that things will not be the same as before, but I know they will be better because when we go through some tough challenges, we learn about who we are and what we value in life. Don't live your life refusing to accept challenges. Challenges are part of our everyday life, whether big or small. And when you overcome those challenges or struggles, you will come back stronger than ever. You've got more tools, technology, and talents than my generation did. It's not the diploma itself that counts. It's what you learn at LTHS. You may not always remember the theories, rules, formulas, terms, or concepts your teachers have tried so hard to teach you, but you will remember the knowledge and experience you had at LTHS. In the Disney movie, Finding Nemo, one line that struck with me is, "Just keep swimming." What a simple statement through the good times and bad. All you have to do is keep going. This sentiment from a fish named Dory has been my mantra for me. You have to keep swimming, keep moving, keep going. We can't wait to see where you all swim off to next. The important thing in your life is to live your life with integrity and not give in to peer pressure. Live your life as an honest and compassionate person. Your future is in your hands, no one else's. Finally, never lose sight of your goals. Remain strong-willed, understanding, and patient. Protect and showcase your talents with confidence and humility. But most important, never lose yourselves or the goodness you can bring to this world. Within you lies the potential for great things. As you go forward in the next phase of your journey, have faith and find strength in one another. Always remember that LTHS and its alumni stand behind you. We believe in you. The relationships you forged as students at LTHS will sustain you throughout your personal and professional lives. On behalf of the Board of Education and I offer you my sincerest congratulations. May all of you fare well on the journey ahead. Members of the audience, please join me in congratulating the class of 2020 on this day, which means so much to them and to their families and friends. And I leave you with the words of our principal, Dr. John Greenham. Go Porters!